Want to know the exact property investment strategy that helped me go from zero to millions right here in South Africa? Imagine unlocking the potential of the country's best kept secret while others are still chasing risky deals. Today, I'm revealing this exact strategy that could change the game for you step by step. And the best part, you can start using it today. And in a few minutes, I'm going to show you the numbers that made my first 1 million rand. Stay with me, because if you leave now, you will miss out on the one mistake that nearly cost me thousands. Trust me, you will want to avoid it. A few years ago, I was just like you, unsure about how to invest in property and nervous about making mistakes. My first investment seemed like a dream come true, but then the reality hit me. I had tenant issues right from the start. Late payment, damage to the property, you name it. At one point, I was paying out of my pocket just to keep things afloat. It felt like everything was falling apart, and I questioned if I made a huge mistake. But I didn't quit. I found the right management team, learned from my mistakes, and refined my strategy. That first property, which seemed like a disaster at the first time, became the stepping stone to everything that followed. Today, I'm sharing that exact strategy with you because it can work for you too. It doesn't require a fortune to start. So, what this strategy? It's called buy to rent, but not just anywhere. There are specific markets in South Africa where you can get high rental yields with relatively low property prices. Areas like Soweto in Johannesburg, Observatory in Cape Town, or Glenwood in Durban suburbs are booming. By renting the property out, you are essentially letting the market pay off your investment. Now, here is where most investors mess up. They miss these three key metrics and lose money. Let me show you how to avoid that. Here is how it works. Look for properties that are priced below market value, perhaps because they need a little work or the owner is selling quickly, but in areas with high rental demand. You are buying at a lower cost but renting at a competitive rate, so you maximize your return. If you are serious about making money in property, you can't avoid to skip this next part. These three metrics could be the difference between success and a major loss. Remember this and you'll be well on your way. To make sure you are picking the right property, focus on these three key metrics. 1. Cost to rent. This is how much you pay for the property compared to how much rent you can earn from it. A higher CTR means you are likely to make profit. For example, if you buy a property for 600,000 rand and can rent it out for 7,500 per month, you are earning around 15% of the property's cost in rent per year. This covers your mortgage and gives you extra profit. 2. Average property value. Compare the price you are paying to the average price of the property in the area. If your property is undervalued, it means you could make a better profit when you sell it later. 3. Annual value per property. This is how much you make in rent per year plus the increase in the property value. If you are earning 90,000 rand in rent per year and your property appreciates by 5%, you are making even more money just by holding onto the property. How would an extra 7,500 a month change your life? What could you do with that passive income? Pay off debt, build savings, or finally start living the lifestyle you want. So remember the three keys: high CTR, below market value, and increasing property value. If you want to know how to identify the right properties and avoid common mistakes, visit PropertyAskEkow.com and book my free consultation. I'm sharing my top tips to make sure your investments are as successful as mine. Now, picture this. What if you found a property like this in your area? Imagine renting it out and letting the market pay off your mortgage while you pocket the profits. Let me break it down further with an example. I found a property in West Dean, Johannesburg, for 500,000 rand, undervalued, because the owner needed to sell quickly. The neighborhood was popular with students and young professionals, so demand was high. I listed the property for $8,000 per month in rent. The rental income not only covered my mortgage, but also left me with a small monthly profit. Over time, the property value increased and I continued to earn rental income. And here is the magic. You can finance most of this property through the rental income. The rent covered almost all my mortgage payments. Over time, you are building wealth without spending much out of your pocket. And in a few minutes, I'm going to show you how I flipped the situation to create passive income every month. Don't go anywhere, because this is where most investors mess up. If this is making sense so far, hit the like button and let me know in the comments below. Which area do you think offers the best rental yields? Soweto, Glenwood, or Observatory? Let me know. Does this strategy seem simple enough? Comment, I'm ready if you are starting to see the potential. Here is the thing. Timing is everything in property investment. Right now, South Africa market is offering some incredible opportunities, but trends change. A recent market report showed that rental demand in key suburbs has increased by 10% over the last year, and prices are still relatively affordable. That's why it's critical to get in while the window is open, because this trend won't last forever. When I purchased a property in Winchester Hills, I made sure to use the big three to guide my decisions. The property cost me 600,000 rand, and after researching the rental market, I found I could charge 7,500 per month in rent. That's a CTR of 15%, which covered my mortgage and gave me some profits. Compared the price to similar properties in the neighborhood, and I noticed that the average value in the area was 650. This means I was buying below market value. Over the first year, I collected 90,000 rand in rent, and the property's value increased by 5%, adding 30,000 rand to its worth. Altogether, the property earned me both rental income and capital appreciation. Your success in property investment comes down to how well you can assess opportunities and present yourself, whether it's to the banks, tenants, or even partners. Stay confident and align your goals with the right strategies. You can do this. Stay tuned, because in the next video, I will share the 7 best steps to buying your dream home while avoiding costly mistakes that could save you thousands. Stick around, because I will also be sharing my top mistakes to avoid in property investment. It could save you thousands. Are you ready to start your investment property journey and make your first million? Comment, I'm a legacy builder, below. Hit the like button and subscribe for more real estate tips. I'm dedicated to your success. Remember, it's all about taking the first step. See you in the next video. Peace.